waterfalls usually form in the upper reaches of the river, where a layer of hard rock overlies a layer of soft rock. An example of this is where there has been a lava flow over softer rock layers. Lava is about 7 out of possible 10 on Mohs scale of hardness. Since lava is a hard rock, it is more resistant to water erosion. A river transversing over a soft rock layer will have a higher rate of erosion than another area with a hard rock layer, such as a lava flow. Over time, the continuing erosion of the softer rocks results in the steepening of the river beyond the end of the lava flow. As the stream bed gets steeper, the velocity of the stream also increases, thereby increasing the stream's erosive power. Eventually, the river's slope becomes vertical, leading to the formation of a waterfall. The base where the waterfall lands is called a plunge pool. Soft rock layers directly under the hard rocks is undercut, creating an overhang. Eventually, the overhanging rock becomes unstable due to the undercutting process, whereby it may collapse and retreat. Mount Ruapehu, an active volcano in New Zealand, has numerous waterfalls that have formed at the end of lava flows. For example, Mangatiro Falls, Tarfai Falls and Taranaki Falls.
I'm standing here at Taranaki Falls. This waterfall is plunging off the end of a lava flow from Mount Ruapehu. Further downstream, the rushing water erodes away the soft banks which are made up of volcanic ash and tephra. The softer materials erode much easier than the hard volcanic rock that you see behind me.
Here is a selection of other waterfalls.